Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the last lesson, we learned how to use formulas to list arithmetic sequences and find specific terms. Now it's time to go the other way, looking at an arithmetic sequence and writing the formula for it. In this video, we're going to be focusing on recursive formulas. Then the next lesson, we'll switch over to explicit. In the previous lesson, you learned that recursive arithmetic formulas look like this. And this would be read as any term in the sequence is equal to the previous term plus the common difference. Also remember that using recursive form requires you to know the first term of the sequence because you have to have a starting point. To put it simply, to write a recursive formula, we need two things, the initial term and the common difference. From this sequence here, we could see that the first term is 25. We can look at the pattern itself and see that it adds 5 every time. So the common difference is 5. Now we've got everything we need to write the recursive formula. Any term is equal to the previous term plus 5 with a first term of 25. And there's our recursive formula. That's all there is to it. Recursive formulas are good to use when you're trying to condense a sequence because they're really easy to write and understand. In this sequence, the first term is 6, and the pattern subtracts 14 over and over. So the common difference is negative 14. The recursive formula will be any term is equal to the previous term minus 14 with an initial term of 6. Pause the video and try this one yourself. Do you think you got it? The first term is negative 7, and the common difference is negative 6. So the recursive formula is the previous term minus 6, starting at negative 7. If you want some extra practice, create your own arithmetic sequences and figure out what their recursive formulas are. In the next lesson, we're going to start by learning how to write explicit formulas for arithmetic sequences. See you then!